Hi, welcome to Morning Prayer.
I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, moving in a mist. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you, I worship you. Light in the darkness, that is who you are. Yeah, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You wipe away all tears, you mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, Jesus. You wipe away all tears, you mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, to it all, Jesus. Yeah. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, I worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you, I worship you. Oh, devotion day, I'm a Zekeyan.
Let us begin. Let all the earth acclaim God. Sing to the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen Lord. Risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Divinity. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. If only you would hear his voice today, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. In a moment of silence, we examine our hearts, our minds, our thoughts, our consciences, and see where we have fallen short of God's requirements and desires for us. And so we bring all before God. We say, Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 30 and 32.
Psalm 30. I will exalt you, O Lord, because you have lifted me up and have not let my enemies triumph over me.
O Lord, my God, I cried out to you, and you restored me to health.
You brought me up, O Lord, from the dead. You restored my life as I was going down to the grave.
Sing to the Lord, you servants of his. Give thanks for the remembrance of his holiness.
For his wrath endures but the twinkling of an eye, his favor for a lifetime.
Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning.
While I felt secure, I said, I shall never be disturbed. You, Lord, with your favor, made me as strong as the mountains.
Then you hid your face, and I was filled with fear.
I cried to you, O Lord. I pleaded with the Lord, saying,
what profit is there in my blood if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you or declare your faithfulness?
Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper.
You have turned my wailing into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy.
Therefore, my heart sings to you without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give you thanks forever.
Psalm 32. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven, and whose sin is put away.
Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, and in whose spirit there is no guile.
While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long.
For your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up as in the heat of summer.
Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not conceal my guilt.
I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord. Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin.
Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in the time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them.
You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eyes.
Do not be like horse or mule, which have no understanding, which must be fitted with bit and bridle, or else they will not stay near you.
Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord.
Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Shout for joy, all who are true of heart.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of the Lord, written in Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 13, verses 1 to 7. Let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those authorities that exist have been instituted by God. Therefore, whoever resists authority resists what God has appointed, and those who resist will incur judgment. For rulers are not a terror to good conduct, but to bad. Do you wish to have no fear of the authority? Then do what is good, and you will receive its approval. For it is God's servant for your good. But if you do what is wrong, you should be afraid, for the authority does not bear the sword in vain. It is the servant of God to execute wrath on the wrongdoer. Therefore, one must be subject not only because of wrath, but also because of conscience. For the same reason, you also pay taxes, for the authorities are God's servants, busy with this very thing. Pay to all what is due them, taxes to whom taxes are due, revenue to whom revenue is due, respect to whom respect is due, honor to whom honor is due. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Song of the Redeemed. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth. O King of all the ages, who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of the Lord, written in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 26, verses 26 to 35. While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will never again drink of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night. For it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." And Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I was looking at the supermoon a couple nights ago and was amazed. Not so much by the moon, its beauty, yes, but amazed at God's power and awesomeness. When we think sometimes, you know, he can't do better than that. We have a super moon. We have a red moon. I'm pretty sure somewhere in some years we might have a blue moon as well. Who knows? But sometimes we underestimate God and his power, God and his will, God and his ability to do things, you know? And I just want us to know or be reminded that God can use anything and anyone to be glorified, to achieve his will and purpose. God can use anything and anyone to achieve his will and purpose. And I was reminded of that just looking at this amazing moon. You know, how powerful, awesome, and mighty this God is. How much light he brings into the darkness. Jesus is sitting with his disciples. And we know this familiar story of the introduction of the Holy Communion, or Holy Eucharist as we call it, the institution. And he is using the Passover feast. We know the Passover feast, when Moses was bringing the people out of bondage and they had to mark the lamb's blood and so forth. And lamb's blood signifying freedom. The blood signifying release, the same blood that where we had the first murder known to humankind in the Bible, where a brother slayed a brother, where at a point where a sacrifice, they were supposed to be giving a sacrifice to God, and because of jealousy and a whole host of other things, he slew his brother. So blood was shed. And so Jesus is here using the same Passover feast, having a meal with his brethren, his friends, his loved ones, as he called them. And reminding us, yes, do this in remembrance of me. Feed on me. Follow his words, listen to him, do what he did. Keep close to him, keep nourishing in his words and the deeds and so forth in your relationship with him. But he's, yes, but he's also saying to them, you are my loved ones. I care for you. You love me. I love you. Early morning chopper passing to the stable. Sorry. So he's there saying to them, I love you. You love me. We've spent so much time together. I've taught you so many things. You've learned from me. And yet one of you will betray me. One of you will betray me. And of course, they are a bit antsy and trying to confess, we will never betray you, we will never leave you, we will stay with you always, and so forth. But he then repeats it for them, that one of my friends, one of you will betray me. And solidifying the blood being shed, just as it was shed in the first place, being shed again to save. One was to destroy, but this one to save. And while that is there lingering, it's there in my head how amazing God is. For even in this moment of breaking of trust and hope and friendship and all of that, he uses, God uses this evil deed, this wicked deed, to glorify himself. God uses this wicked deed to prove that he's even greater than evil, that he can make good come out of something bad. What good came out of it? Salvation for all of us. Proven time and time again his love for us, saving us, mercy, opportunities to come, saving the whole human race. He used evil and made something good. And that is the point I want us to cherish and be reminded of. That he is, while we are struggling, while we can't see the end, while we are frustrated, while we are stressed, while we're concerned about what is going to happen next, while we're concerned about how things are going, while we are worried and fearful of our current situation, whatever it may be, he's the way maker. He's the light in the darkness. He is the only true source of hope. He's the one that can turn things around for us. But in all of it, it requires faith. It requires trust. It requires obedience. So even when we are having our communion, when we are engaging in the breaking of bread, it requires faith. It requires trust. It requires obedience. Because it is in that we're able to grow deeper. We're able to understand the sacrifice he has made for us. We're able to receive what he is giving and pouring out to us. And receiving is not that because it's there, you know. It's as though somebody has brought a cake for you and you rest it on the table and you walk away and you never look back at it. Or you just say, well, yes, that's there. That's not receiving. When we cut it, when we show gratitude for it, when we ingest and digest, we've received. And so it is not just that God has given, but we have to receive it. We have to receive it, and we receive it through faith, and we have to strengthen our faith. Faith is not just in that moment and it stays there. Faith is meant to be grown. Faith is meant to be developed. Faith is meant to be strengthened. It is also in our obedience. In our obedience does not only mean to stay still, but there are things that we must action. In our trust, we cannot go complaining, we cannot go frustrated, we cannot go double-minded, but focused on God. This is what he wants us to do. Trusting in his promises, being confident that what he is saying to us is the truth, is the way, is the life. My friends in Christ,
this awesome and mighty, very powerful, amazing God sheds the light in the darkness, disperses the darkness in our lives, the evil that might be surrounding us, the evil and wicked people that are around us. He will destroy them. He will sweep all of them up, and he will rid this land of the plague. But we must be focused that we do not end up on that side, but always triumphant with the Lord. So while Jesus has this discourse with his disciples, and it's very disappointing, in you know, because they eventually denied him and they disappeared and so forth. Even though they said, I wouldn't. But what was good is that they saw the error of their ways and they came back. He didn't even leave them. He did not leave them. While it seemed for a moment that he did leave them, he came back. He showed himself that I have always been with you, proving to us that his promise is true. His promise is true. I am with you always. Friends in Christ, God is with you always. Stay faithful, stay true. And even when you've made that mistake, return to him, because he is your champion. He is working for you. He will bring good out of evil. He will bring good out of bad, through our struggles, through our frustrations. He's right there with us and will see us through for betterment. What we are required to do is be faithful, be obedient, and be trusting in him. Draw close to him. Draw close to him. Stay within his bosom. Stay under his wings by reading his word, by being faithful in prayer, by being faithful to his commandments, and try your very best to love him and to love others. Amen.
Standing here
only because you made
you made
And so we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. O Lord, mercifully receive the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may know and understand what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to accomplish them. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. So we offer prayers to God for those for in this time of trouble. Grant us, O Lord, our God, ever to find in you a very present help in trouble. When we are in the darkness of doubt or perplexity, shed your light upon our way. When we are burdened with the affairs of our daily life, let us to the calm of your presence. When we are battling with temptation and the flesh is weak, by the might of your Spirit, make us strong to overcome. We ask these things through him in whom we are more than conquerors, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit. And in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. Have a blessed weekend, everyone.